feel so good it should cost. Bought an alligator, I ain't talking Lacoste. Made me say,
Your pay site, PayPal. This guy is a real con man. How do you become the richest man in the world? And it's like, oh, you just sell Teslas? What else is he selling? Where is he? How is he the richest man in the world? There's 150 Teslas on the road right now. That's it. Something is up with that Musk.
Tesla is a really popular stock, people are saying.
Oh, yeah. More popular than anything in the world.
That's what they
think
say.
About that. That's a sneaky man. So what was I saying? The richest man in the world. Well, why did I bring him up?
Because
here this
in
time?
Contrast
In
to...
contrast. So Joe Rogan is sitting there literally with the richest man in the world. Is it the world or United States?
The world.
The world?
Yes.
That's scary.
He passed Jeff Bezos.
That's scary. Imagine knowing the richest man in the world. I would not even want to know the richest man in the world.
Of course not.
Think about what it would take to become the richest man the world has ever seen. Frightening! And Joe doesn't even consider how frightening that could be. You don't become the richest man in the world because you're doing something cool. Think about what he must have done to become the richest man in the world. Shame on you for being fooled by the richest man the world has ever known. That's fucking scary. That to me is up there with the guy who's murdered the most people. The richest man in the world? That's not to be celebrated. All right. Here it is. Brian Redban. Friends with the second richest man in the world. Co-creator of the Joe Rogan Experience, the richest podcast in the world. Whose best friend is the richest man in the world. Certainly, Brian Redban should have power.
Yikes. Is where the intro ends.
Thank God I look at the chat for 1 second. The first thing I see is Mike is so fucking right. Thank you. Mike is still richer in the qualities that matter. Aww. Thank you so much. I am very close. I'm probably the fourth or fifth richest man in the world. As far as smallest ball size goes. All right. Time code me. Let's open. Let's see the opening. I love
it's
an opening.
2 minutes
Are people enjoying
long.
The show or do you want it to be completely canceled, buried under the dirt, and everyone's here to make fun of me only?
You got to go to 2:45 to skip the intro.
Okay.
The beginning.
It's only 2:45. Okay. 2:45. And we're going to see Brian now. People asked, how is he broadcasting inside a house with no heat? Nobody knows. Let's see what happens here. Mike. If he can't do it, no one can. I'm much better than Elon Musk. I might start my own electric car company. It's a car that's electric in the sense where you get into that seat and then this happens. You get electrocuted to death. Cut that shit. You die because you were so greedy you wanted an electric vehicle. Here. A virtual Redban. Here you go. Let's see what happens here. They're freezing in Austin. There he is. Oh, of course,
his
audio.
What is up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Virtual Redban. Number 183. Can you believe that?
How cold is it in VR right now? Are they feeling the effects, or can they not get into their fake land where everybody is like a Pokemon character walking around? With a muffled voice. Here he is, Brian Redban. He's got a fake slot machine behind him, a Nintendo. Imagine going out and going, oh, I need the new... they make a Nintendo where you can play any game. It's over. Zelda, I don't know what he is. He's in a white abyss. Look at that antenna sticking up there. He's wearing this fake, supreme, powerful JRE sweatshirt. Let's hear what he says.
I've done 183 of these motherfuckers. And you guys wow. are watching it. Cool. I am back. From the dead. Woo! Honestly,
hold on, I love this guy.
Plug my phone in.
Hillbilly. He's a hillbilly right. now too.
I am. I am back from the dead. I have had a since you last saw me, which I think the last episode we did was Monday. Was it Monday? No, I don't remember when the last episode was. But right after that episode, that's when the shit went down. It was Sunday. Right after Sunday's episode, about an hour after the episode, we lost power. And in the last, up to this morning, Wednesday, so about over 72 hours, we have had not had power. We had brief, like...
I don't understand. Your shirt says powerful. You know, if anyone doesn't think this is a plague based on Joe Rogan's greed, what happened to Texas? I mean, you're just really not reading the right books.
Can you believe this happened, by the way?
This will always happen to my enemies. Every one of my enemies gets it in the worst way. You can never predict what's going to happen. Somebody would have told me Texas would freeze to death and all their power would stop working and Brian Redban's Tesla would be of no use, I'd go, I don't know, it sounds pretty far-fetched! Which is where Chris D'Elia got his shirt, farfetch.com. It's the only place.
Three times the power came on, like for like 30 minutes, 45 minutes, something like that, at a time. And it was always horrible. It was like 5 in the morning, the power's on, and you're like, what the fuck? It's on! Charge everything! Turn on the heat! Check the internet to make sure everything's okay! You know, it was horrible.
He's got hives.
Now, I've lived in Ohio for 30 years before I moved to Los Angeles. Even in Ohio, I never had it where I lost power more than a day. And they had, the snowstorm that Texas had was probably like a normal Friday in Ohio. It wasn't that bad.
Wow.
It was just some ice and some snow. I mean, we got like, I think in where I live, we got about 6 to 8 inches of snow. But the bad thing was, is we did get ice, and then we got snow, and then we got, today, we got even crazier ice.
We got ice. Imagine that. You know, I got ice the other day, too. At the store, before I went camping! It was like 79 degrees that day. We got ice. We got ice. 6 to 8 inches, my old dick says. Let's see what he says next.
We got a lot of ice and a lot of snow. But normally, that's not a big deal. You know, you got the crews working on the roads. Your infrastructure is made for it. Texas doesn't have that. Where I live, if you Google where I live, and you said, what's the average amount of snow you get every year? And trust me, that's one of the things I did when I bought, when I moved here.
Whoa! Making sure that when I bought. When I moved here, wait a minute, why interrupt yourself and change the story there, change the facts?
He did say that he bought it before, though, for sure, right?
Are you saying you didn't buy your house? Well, I hope you're not renting your house. That's a fool's move, especially someone in your position. And I really hope Joe Rogan didn't buy your house. Uh-oh, let's hear that again. When I moved... And only an idiot like him would even allow himself to interrupt himself in such like a fictional way. You'd only see that in a movie. That's similar to somebody going, hey, did you steal my car? And they go, no. Okay. Only in a movie would that work. Let's hear this.
And you said, what's the average amount of snow you get every year? And trust me, that's one of the things I did when I bought... When I moved here, I was making sure that there was no snow, and it's 0.0. No lie, where I live, the average amount of snow is 0.0, not 0.1, not 0.2, 0.0 inches of snow a year. Well, that record, it's fucked, but that's the biggest problem. Texas doesn't even have ice, you know, ice machines, like snow plows. They don't even have, I think they have like a couple.
No ice machines. How are the people in the hotels going to have a cold drink? Ice machines. Only the ice machines were working, we'd have power. What an idiot. This guy's like 48 years old as well. Texas doesn't have ice machines. They've got the, you know, the sound, him and that young Jamie, they're both like 45 years old, and they've both got like the tone of their voice has like that childlike slop to it. You know, I can't explain it. It doesn't sound like a kid's voice, but it's got the pacing of a child. You know, there's something got messed up along the way.
For the whole city, probably. But where I live, they haven't touched the roads. They don't use salt because they don't have salt. Because they don't have ice. So, like, they have, like, sand. They throw sand on bridges. Like, sand is going to do shit. What the fuck?
So yeah, sand actually works really well. For filling my clogs! What's sand going to do? I don't know. Why don't you go ask Tony Hinchcliffe?
The roads here are just destroyed. The power companies, you guys probably have seen the news. You guys know what happened. The power companies, their generators, their gas generators all froze.
Yes.
So their gas generators couldn't keep up with
Can
the power.
Can Rogan
whatever.
Invite him over to his house?
I like don't understand.
A gigantic mansion.
Joe Rogan has more rooms than Michael Jordan did in the 90s. Joe Rogan's house is literally like a fucking plantation. Have you ever seen the aerial view of Joe Rogan's house? It literally, it's bigger than the Buckingham Palace. It has so many rooms, and each one of those rooms has power and its own generator.
Joe Rogan is like Joel Osteen.
Yes.
He wouldn't let the people come into his church during the hurricane.
The mighty Joe Stones.
Yes.
Joe Rogan is no different than the mighty Gemstones. And it's like, you can't let Brian come over and share your stuff. I don't think Rogan was home. I think Rogan was out in the Bahamas with Logan Paul, hanging by the pool in his floaties.
We're fucking shit.
Listen,
we lost this. Our power. We lost our water. Our water just came on about an hour ago. But it's no boil, meaning like the water is gross and you're not supposed to really drink it. And if you do have to drink it, boil it.
So why is it no boil?
Yeah.
So
it's no boil.
No internet. T-Mobile, which is my cell phone provider.
Why don't you just drink all the SpaghettiO juice from the cans? You know, you got plenty of that. Why don't you wring out the grudge? Doesn't the grudge come with a line of water when she walks? Isn't that part of her thing? Like
it
everywhere she
goes. Freezes, though.
Yeah, I don't know. Isn't that like a. Doesn't she? Or that's the ring. Yeah.
Well, no, the grudge. Didn't she come out of a bathtub?
Yeah.
So that makes sense.
Your girlfriend, just look at the trail of water she leaves. Or is that dark water? You can't drink that.
Still out.
No boil.
Still no T-Mobile. 3 days, four
Wish
days,
I had no,
no cell phone service. So I was in the pitch dark,
oh,
no internet,
nice,
no phone, which is scary as fuck when you're like, what the fuck's happening? No water, pitch black. We had like...
But you live in a life of no water. Thank God that he is used to this. He doesn't drink water to begin with. You know, wait till you see what he's been drinking to survive off of. I can't even believe this is possible. 7 days. He's been drinking. Wait till you hear what he says.
Couple candles and one like lantern, like rechargeable lantern that luckily was charged. So we had some lights. But man, our place got down to 45 was the coldest it got inside the
That's
house.
That's nothing.
Now I know it's like, oh, I can live a couple of days with no power. I agree. But when your house is 45 degrees, I mean, that's almost freezing. That means inside your house, you would start getting ice. It was so cold one night that I was in four layers. Like, I think I still have like two layers on because I'm just in shell shock. But there
what
was like.
It turned out that Rogan invited Tim Dillon over and Tony.
And didn't invite
Redman.
No, you didn't hear about this. People go, Mike, we haven't heard from Tony Hinchcliffe. He passed away.
Tony motherfucking Hinchcliffe.
He literally turned into an icicle and then cracked. Yeah, Tony's dead.
Last night, remember?
Tony's dead. Oh, yeah, last night. Tell him what you said last night. Tell him what you said.
I just turned to you and I was like, imagine if Redban literally
froze to
death and died
and
because
died.
Of Rogan.
And we said, we'll take it. I would... actually want one of them to die to show this Rogan that everything isn't a game. It's not a game. Moving 45,000 people to Austin is not something that you're capable of. It's not something you did. You know, didn't the Pied Piper walk a bunch of people into a fire or something like that?
Really? I thought he saved them from a fire.
Well,
no,
believe
me,
there's...
No, he saved them from snakes. He saved the snakes from the town.
I'm telling you.
The town from the snakes.
Yeah, but Joe Rogan can't play any instruments. There's a big difference. So you shouldn't be doing this unless you could fully take care of your people. You know, he's acting like Moses when he took these guys into the Red Sea. And what happened, of course, the Red Sea closed up. As soon as Moses got to the edge, the Red Sea closes up and all those Jewish people were murdered. So I can't allow this to happen. I might call the governor myself, Governor Ted Cruz. Tell him what's been going on.
One night it was so cold that I had like four layers
Listen
on, four pairs of sweatpants on.
It was so
we
cold.
Had, like comfies on and hats.
Comfies.
The dogs are shivering.
Yes.
We're in under like seven blankets in our bed and we're just fucking sitting there going like, I couldn't even sleep. It was so cold.
This is perfect for me.
It was freezing and it was very torturous not having
Oh,
it
was torturous and freezing. You want to ask how I've been doing? Nah, I shouldn't. I shouldn't brag. But I will say, absolutely a fucking amazing! You understand? It just doesn't get any better. So torturous, freezing, seven blankets. Sounds like you probably should have stayed in sunny Los Angeles. Ah, how interesting. There's a couple more parts I want to play for you.
There's one more good part coming up.
Yeah, listen to this.
Shit. And luckily, the power...
And by the way, like, we go camping, and it's 45 degrees at night and in the morning. It's fine. You get into one sleeping bag with your clothes on. You put one blanket over you. You're in a tent. What are these people complaining about? I don't understand. You even... The sleeping bags, like, 40-degree sleeping bags are like the... highest degree you could get, like the lowest, you know what I mean? People go, what about them? These people are real big babies. You know, put some shit together, eat some shit, light a fire, figure it out. It's 4 days of a light snowfall. 45 degrees, by the way, isn't that cold. It's 45 degrees every morning here. I go out,
wow,
I'm running around.
Didn't get down to like 15 degrees though?
There, for them?
And
he's saying it was 49 degrees in my house.
Inside the house.
I remember an episode of All My Children. Do you remember this this show, All My Children? My mom used to watch these shows. These were called soap operas. All My Children, and the show was shot in California. I didn't know anything about other weather when I was that age. But I remember a scene from All My Children where this little rich fucking kid goes to visit Santa. And the Santa goes, what do you want for Christmas, little boy? And he goes, I want it to snow. And Santa looked at the camera and said, it's 50 degrees and the kid wants it to snow. I'll never forget that line. And then I went, 50 degrees? That's pretty cold, right? Or is that warm? Too warm for... I don't know. I'm a kid. And, but again, 50 degrees. Santa was saying, no, you can't have snow in 50 degrees. They're living in basically 50 degrees. What's wrong with 50 degrees? 50 bucks? That's a lot. 50 has always been a high number. Even today, 50 bucks sounds like a lot still to me. 50 cents is even a nice amount of change. Everything in the 50s is high. Age, if somebody's 50 years old, whoa, it's a full adult. So I don't buy it.
This morning, about 5, 6 a.m., something like that, we've had power all day. This episode might only last if this for some reason this episode...
You know, it's so funny, they all left, of course, Los Angeles because they couldn't do their comedy shows because of COVID. And now they can't do their comedy shows because of Snowvid and Mike David. By the way, I created all this. People want to blame China, blame my wishes. I said this, you know, that's what I said. They got $100 million. Oh, that's why I brought up Elon Musk. Joe Rogan's got $100 million. He's friends with Elon Musk. Seems to be pretty unstoppable. That's a pretty tough one for me to take down, right? Well, when I saw that, I said, well, luckily I made about 200 million wishes for his demise. That should cover it. And if you guys all make a few million wishes, we should be able to get this done in the next 6 months.
One wish per dollar.
One wish per dollar.
I'm not out of it yet. We just had an ice storm. On top of all
yes,
this,
I know.
We had an
Shut
ice
up.
Storm today, which dropped just.
What is an ice storm? It's dropping ice. You guys should move. keep moving until you hit the lake.
Buckets of ice on top of everything. So like my front driveway is about that thick.
Listen to this. This is so funny.
It's a straight up ice skating rink.
It's an ice skating rink.
I tried to open my garage door.
Why don't you, instead of a Tesla, you should have bought a Zamboni.
Brian Redban.
Do you know what a Zamboni is? It's the thing that smooths out the ice.
Of course I know that.
Yeah, of course she knows that. She grew up in a rink. Instead of a Tesla, you should have bought a Zamboni. That's going to be the newest car.
Sorry, I was looking for that part where he says he slips.
Does Elon Musk make an all-electric Zamboni yet?
Like, nope. It's frozen shut.
Listen to this. You're going to love this.
It's crazy. So, yeah, that's what I've been dealing with. I'm tired, out of control tired of just not having power. I haven't showered.
These are the most energetic, out of control, tired slobs I've ever met. You know, he's always doing a comedy show or streaming and talking. How does somebody so fat? I talk for, the 8 hours and then I'm in bed all week. I can't imagine. These guys really know how to be energetic and so tired at the same time. That's not really a diss to them.
4 days.
Listen to this, though.
Because we just got our water on. Speaking of water, can't drink ice cubes. I have an ice maker in my refrigerator, and the power just came on, and I can't drink the ice cubes that thing's making because you have to boil it. So just, I went.
Did you ever consider letting them melt? You know, they're not going to stay frozen in a cup, will they?
But he has to boil them to get the bacteria out.
Yeah, and but I don't understand. Doesn't his stove work? He's got a gas stove. Turn on the gas and light it. I don't understand what's going on. Why aren't the gas lines working? What does that have to do with power?
I don't think that they get some of their power from gas.
Why don't you start a little fire? I mean, doesn't he have a fireplace? Just go outside and build a fire. What's the problem? Go outside, build a fire. Burn some of this fucking shit. The box for the Nintendo, you don't need to collect that. You take that outside, you light it on fire, and you melt the ice cubes, you survive. It doesn't take Elon Musk to figure this one out.
Now and got a bunch of snow.
Listen to wait. Listen to this. I got my enemies eating snow. Something I haven't done since I was six. I got my enemies eating snow for dinner. Listen to this, asshole.
Toilet. So I went out and got a bunch of snow. Put it in some Tito's and some green Monster energy drinks.
Listen to this. He's drinking Monster energy drinks to survive. Imagine that. He doesn't have any water, doesn't have any food, doesn't have any heat, doesn't have any power. He's got Monster energy drinks and snow, and he's mixing it with vodka. That's good.
So gross.
What a nice survival meal.
Drinking snow. My girlfriend Janice thinks that is horrible and gross. Took off a layer of ice and then
you know what I think's horrible and gross? Her! The movie. Seen that film? I don't like it.
I kind of
like
it.
Middle of the snow, put it in there. Put it actually on a plate. Made sure there's no poop or yellow parts or blueberries or whatever the fuck's in there. It
Why would there
fine,
be blueberries
so
in your
it
snow?
It melted immediately, though. But so I guess I don't even need to put snow in it.
Look at this. What are you talking about?
Cheers.
There's got to be water in Monster energy drink. I've never understood how that works myself. If something is liquid, there's water in it, right? It's not just an unknown liquid.
And also, if it's so freezing in your house, isn't your Monster energy and your vodka chilled enough to just drink it without ice? Why do you need
Wait a minute. He brought in the snow just to chill his Monster energy drinks that should be cold enough to drink on their own if everything's frozen.
Yes.
This is so absurd. And why can't he use his ice cubes? He said
they're made of the water that's apparently contaminated.
Why is the water contaminated?
Apparently because so many pipes burst, I guess.
Oh. So sorry. My water is drinkable.
It's got parasites, they're saying.
Oh, your water has parasites. That's interesting. Maybe try some vitamin D.
I should just make a second drink.
Imagine taking a full sip of snow. That's a new one. This is really Amazing. What will happen next based on my lamp rubbing?
Put it outside and let it freeze while I'm drinking this drink.
Nope. Not smart at all, actually. Like, pretty stupid.
It is. How cold is it right now?
Why don't you melt some of your games and drink the plastic?
That's why it was so cold. Well, it's not that cold now. It's 28.
Well, I don't understand. Someone these people don't have lighters or a match?
How dirty the snow is.
Why is the snow dirty? This doesn't make sense either. All right, let's see this picture. The snow is dirty. So
a random picture, but I assume it's true.
Look at this. He goes, okay, so y'all go ride it. By the way, if you use the word y'all, you deserve to drink brown snow. Y'all go right ahead and eat your snow fluff. I'm good. So this guy is showing in his bathtub. He's got a bunch of mashed potatoes. They look perfect. As it melts, it reveals the true color. So I guess, yeah, when the snow's falling from the sky, it's picking up dirt, dust, all that stuff. So it appears to be white, but when it melts, it reveals the dirt. No different from when his girlfriend steps out of the tub after just dipping in her big toe. I don't know why he's afraid to drink that. That's what his girlfriend was born from. So, yeah, it's just, it couldn't be better for me. Now, it does get better, actually. There's another story Brian's going to tell. Should I keep playing it here?
No, that's on a different one, the part you were talking
about.
Okay.
So should I zoom out of this, or should we play a couple parts from this? Or
pretty much the end of that.
This next one.
This one is actually from before this, when it first started happening.
Let's listen to more Slob Diaries, and let's play you this. Is this queued up?
Yes, I hope this is the part you're talking about. 233.
Okay, so this is 233. Here's another one from Brian Redband's diaries. Only he's dumb enough to say all this stuff for me. Listen to this.
Guys, let me just fix something. Happy virtual Redband Saturday. Sunday. Wait, today's Sunday. I don't even know what day it is. I don't know. Welcome to virtual Redband number 182.
So this is the day before.
During an ice storm still.
Listen to this.
Today was a lot worse. Today we actually, I woke up and it was straight up ice everywhere. Like, I did not know what happened over the night last night. And I did the classic step on the driveway and then just slowly trying to catch my balance and slid down my whole entire driveway and fell on my ass in the sidewalk. And no, my cameras did not catch it.
Okay, so he fell. He did the fat man's ice fall, which is nice. They're slipping and falling in their own homes. I love it. I just couldn't be happier. And again, people go, don't you care about it? No, I don't care if my brother lives or dies. If it's happening to these people, if they can't drink, they're eating snow, I'm very happy.
Your brother's fine. He had one package of ground beef.
Yeah, my brother had one package of ground beef. He said it's terrible. He said he can't even leave the house because his car is rear-wheel drive. It won't go back up his driveway. It's too steep, so they can't leave.
Oh,
I could go anywhere. I could go anywhere with my 35s. All right, well, very exciting. In Austin, we wish you the worst. I can't wait. I hope a volcano blows up.
Unless you're here in the chat from Austin.
Yeah, well, hey.
In that case, I'm sorry.
Well, we
this
made a deal.
Fault.
We made a deal on the last show. We said, if you live in Austin, we'll get you out. All right?
Yes.
We'll get you out of there. That way we could all keep making fun of Austin and it won't hurt your feelings. Okay.